Hi guys, thanks for joining me for another Affinity Designer tutorial. Today I'm going to be going over how to use the export persona right after this. Okay, so here we have a few shapes that I created really quickly. You can do this as well, or you can just go ahead and click and download it in the description. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and click on the export persona. And here, as you can tell, the tools have automatically changed over here. There's only four tools, and the panels have changed a little bit, and up here at the toolbar up here is lots of stuff has come down, but you can view your thing in different modes right here, different view modes. Okay, so here there's this unique new tool. It's called the sliced tool. It's unique to the export persona, and what this tool does is it allows you to just click and drag and create slices this way. And delete the slice, just hit delete on a Mac. And then there's the selection tool, just the normal tool like in the draw persona or in the pixel persona. Then there's the view tool. You can pan, you can zoom up here. Then there's also the zoom tool, which allows you to zoom up by dragging. And I don't think you would really use these tools too much because you've got all your shortcuts and everything, so but these tools are definitely more important. So here I have a slice of this triangle, and we're on the slices panel. Slices panel has all the different slices you have, so it's named slice 1. To rename it, go ahead and double click on it and name it triangle. And you can turn the slice off and on. You can adjust the slice if you want. I'm not going to go ahead and do that. But, so it also takes the background as well and sort of makes that a slice. It's not really a slice, but it's, you can export it. So this is where you export everything. I'll talk about exporting it in a second. I'm just going to go ahead and click on layers first. Okay, so here on layers, you can see that there's a little export icon right here next to the triangle because it has a slice around it. If I wanted to create a slice exactly around this cog shape, then what you need to do is click on your selection tool here, select your cog tool, and then make sure it's sort of bluish outline, and then right click, and it will come up with create slice. Now it's created a slice, and I can do the same with the others. Click here, create slice, click here, create slice, and so on. So you can create slices from any of your layers. That's pretty useful if you want to just export these. And then when you go to export them, you're going to go ahead and click on export options. And you can create presets here. And as you can tell, I've already created a HDR preset, but there's all these other presets that you can create. I'm going to go ahead and click on PNG 24, and then I'm going to click on slices. So I got all these different slices, and I'm going to rename them to what they are. Okay, so I've got these all named, and then I could go ahead and click export slices down here, this little button that says export slices, then it has a little 8 and it shows how many slices you have, or you can export them individually. I'm going to go ahead and export one of them individually so you'll know what this means. Click here on the export thing, and it will automatically name your thing triangle. You can go ahead and export it to pictures and click export. And that one's exported. These are all not PNG. To change the settings, click down here and change HDR to PNG. So I can go ahead and export that, but I'm going to go ahead and export all the rest of them just without being PNGs. And I'm going to go ahead and export all slices except for the triangle because I already did that one. So just uncheck it right here. And I'm going to uncheck the background. And I'm going to export slices. I'm going to go ahead and create a new folder and call it slices. And click export. The export persona is an amazing persona for exporting icons such as shapes or just different icons for website design and PNGs and logos. It's just a great workspace put aside for exporting. So now I'm just going to go ahead and show you my file. Okay, so I'm in my files, and I'm going to show you where all those slices went. So I'm going to drag this triangle into the slices folder that I made. And as you can see here, here are all the slices. The HDRs don't give you a little preview of what it looks like because it's an HDR. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Hope it answered some of your questions about the export persona. And I hope you join me again for another tutorial. Thanks.